seconds vamping, please. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us again for another beautiful intermezzo concert this Wednesday evening, coming to you live from Gallivan Center in collaboration with the Excellence in the Community concert series. We are here with a kind sponsorship from several organizations to whom I would like to express my thanks for their support. Of course, our friends at Excellence, as well as the Gallivan Center, Danes Music for the beautiful Steinway piano they provide for each concert, the Salt Lake City Redevelopment Agency, Salt Lake City Mayor Aaron Mendenhall, and Salt Lake City Council. Also, Utah State Division of Arts and Museums. The quartet that you just heard was composed by a very, very young musician, only 16 years of age, by the name of Arriaga. Arriaga was a child prodigy and often compared to Mozart, not only because of his prolific abilities as a young musician, he was also coincidentally born on the same day as Mozart, 27th of January. So they shared the birthday, and I believe also one of the names, christening names. At any rate, Arriaga came to Paris to study at the Paris Conservatory, and his teachers were incredibly impressed with his abilities. He started out as quite a young genius and had a meteoric rise in the French society and educational system. His teacher was one of other string quartet famous composers, Luigi Cherubini. And unfortunately, Arriaga was pretty worn out with the pace that was set for him because of his abilities, and we don't quite know why or how what happened, but he seemed to have died from a lung ailment, possibly tuberculosis, at 10 days short of his 20th birthday. So the number of his works is quite small, and the three string quartets date from year 1823. The next work on the program is by Johannes Brahms. Brahms wrote this version of the quintet, well, he okayed this version of this work in 1864 after having tried the material in the form of a string quintet, which he destroyed because he was a perfectionist, and during his lifetime ended up burning and destroying a lot of his works. He was very aware of the fact that he had a legacy to maintain, a reputation to maintain, and any work that didn't quite meet his standard, he just disposed of. So we've lost a lot of his works, and so the string quartet version does not exist any longer. He did commit the material to a work for two pianos, and then eventually settled on it being a piano quintet, which kind of in a way combines the string quintet and the two piano idea. So the work itself is broadly majestic and somewhat dark and stormy most of the time. There are some moments of repose and quiet contentment is how one could describe it. For example, in the second movement, which is very reminiscent of the lullaby that he wrote another time, and it's very gentle and lilting music. The outer movements, the first, the third, and the fourth, are quite energetic and very reliant on a symphonic type of writing for the quartet and the piano, and they do integrate quite a lot of Hungarian motifs and themes and rhythms of which Brahms was so fond. So thank you again for joining us tonight, and enjoy this piece, and join us again next Wednesday, and the first Wednesday in March. We will bring you more beautiful classical music. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.